Hello and welcome to another explosively depressing episode of What Happened, the show where we crack open the powder kegs of fiery failure that have left shockwaves all over the bomb puns! Cause Bomberman! Ever since we opened up our stage, there's been a constant hum, a buzz, if you will, to cover one of the earliest, most spectacular faux pas in the HD generation of gaming. Bomberman, Act Zero, or Zero Hour, I confuse the two sometimes. Anyway, I've said it before, so I'll say it again, the seventh generation was rough, y'all. Dog rough. Because breaking through those skyrocketing budgets and Unreal 3's poor texture load-in and coming out the other side as a success was a fairly rare occurrence. Hudson Soft made a name for themselves through the 80s and 90s with franchises like Adventure Island, Bonk, Bloody Roar, and on top of them all, Mylon's Secret Castle, so they weren't the best equipped to compete with the gloppy gray shooters of the HD era, and their premier character, Bomberman, was the illest equipped of all. Now let's take a closer look at this man of bombs, this Bomberman. Adorable little expressive eyes, bright colorful costume, he's just so very kawaii! And of course, he wields weapons of mass destruction that cause pillars of fiery death that chase people down hallways. Gee, I wonder which of these aspects will make it into the Xbox 360.
Hey kids, do you know Bomberman?
Yeah!
Shut the fuck up! This is Bomberman Extreme! Are you prepared for his Act Zero?
No.
Good, then get ready for Body Horror! Techno-organic cyber infusion! Big fat anime titties! No local multiplayer, all the things you love about Bomberman. So, tell your folks, buy me Zero out, Act Zero, or go to hell.
Oh, that's not good for my voice. So, yeah, for HD consoles, Hudson Soft tried. They tried something different with Bomberman. Now, if history is any indicator, and it most of the time is, whenever a new generation kicks off, the first genre that blows up the hardest is what other companies will try to emulate for the next few years. For example, Grand Theft Auto 3 spawned many similar open-world sandboxes. Therefore, Gears of War spawned many Gears of War. Japanese publishers were already trying to adjust to the fluctuating tastes of the West, even at the tail end of the PS2 and Xbox's life. You'd start to see cheap attempts to cash in on violent, more darker affair. Stuff like Konami's Nano Breaker, Capcom's Shadow of Rome or Beatdown, or Namco's Urban Reign. So the seeds were being planted nice and early. In addition, with Xbox Live and online multiplayer's burgeoning popularity, Hudson also felt it best to get on that train as well, and hey, they chose to do so with their flagship franchise, which is something that should have never happened. But why did this all happen? Well, an article via The Cartel that no longer exists online, but was archived, written by one John Lee, paints a picture on why is it gotta be like this. Hudson felt this overwhelming need to please its shareholders, so games like Bomberman Act Zero came to be. Before the US division of Hudson was fully established, the remaining creative minds in Hudson wanted to update Bomberman to cater to Westerners. The company believed that the US was an opportunity to grow again. Unfortunately, the game was developed in a vacuum and was based on what the Japanese thought Western tastes in gaming were. Without the original Bomberman creator on board to protect the brand and without input from US operations, which at the time didn't have any real developers on board yet, Bomberman was thrust into a post-apocalyptic world that was dark and sinister. Now, for him to fit in this horrific post-apocalyptic world, Bomberman needed to go through some changes. From this little guy into a far more generic, bland, armored, killing synthoid that wouldn't be out of place on any PC accelerator card from like 1998. Some people have theorized that Hudson may have taken inspiration from the original Bomberman design featured on the NES box art, but like, yeah, who does that? Who in their right mind would willingly implement a terrible version of their marquee character into a brand? Regardless, it seems the original Bomberman was indeed a source of inspiration, because in a Japanese interview upon the game's reveal, a very reasonable question was posed to lead game designer Koichi Takashita. The Bomberman series so far featured cartoony characters, but this time it's presented in realistic 3D. Options like cell shading could have been a new way of expressing personality, so why did you go for realistic 3D characters? The new world and design was an order from our producer right at the start. Bomberman's image has been skewed towards younger audiences the past few years. This time, we dropped the comical appearance and decided to build fresh off the origin of Bomberman. The story was already there in the original game on the Famicom. In the manual, it described a story set in a cramped underground dwelling where they aimed to escape to the surface. We looked at that and asked the question, what if it were realistic? So it became Bomberman Act Zero. It wasn't going to be a guide-in story or a what-if tale, it's another take on the source material. That's terrible. Anyway, not content with only just having a muscular badass robo-cyborg synthoid, Hudson realized that American gamers like other things, like bazongas, as was the style at the time. Thus, they also took Pink Bomber, this gal right here, and Todd McFarland her into oblivion, making sure to place emphasis on certain specific areas. These same areas, of course, got special attention in-game as well. Now, that's all fine and good, but why reboot it at all? Act Zero? What does that even mean in regards to Bomberman? Is there any meaning behind the title of Act Zero? To us, Zero means a brand new beginning and a fresh start. In fact, early in development, it was called Bomberman Begins, but because a movie about a certain bat-themed character came out, that title couldn't be used. Act Zero better invoked the image we wanted from Begins anyway. Okay, sure, whatever, dude. Now, this all seems really ill-advised, doesn't it? Well, John Grainer, a former boss at Hudson USA, tried his best to explain why this happened to planet Earth. I think this was a case where Hudson, and we cautioned against it, we said, don't call it Bomberman, you might piss people off. They didn't quite get that, and said, we want to make Bomberman new, you know? People don't want that new, they want new features or something like that, but not a new character. Their point was to make a game that looked new, but also maintained the features and sensibilities of Bomberman. That is a logical plan, a logical approach to putting out good products over a period of time, but they changed the character and world too much. There were good things in Act Zero that everybody ignored because they were so pissed about the character. You're not wrong about that last point. Now, if you want to make a game with a dark, edgy theme with violent overtones and even a bit of titillation, that's fine. Create a brand new franchise that offers those things, but if you take a character or series that's been established for years, decades even, and decide to do the same thing, well, when has that ever worked? Oh, right, never. Fans did not take this new direction well, but it's easy to assume that a percentage of players that enjoyed the Bomberman of old would be able to ignore the ugly reskin and still enjoy that same tried and true gameplay. Those people would be wrong. One of the key things of playing classic Bomberman is situational awareness, being able to see the entire screen and make split-second decisions about bomb placement and enemy positions. Act Zero decided, for some reason, to shift the camera angle to be far lower, limiting that field of vision. Once again, that Japanese interview seems to question this really bad design choice. When people hear Bomberman, they think of the bird's eye view perspective. Why have you adopted the new FPB mode? The classic Bomberman gameplay is still intact. That part of the game has been completed and it is terrific. There are people who wanted to see this new action from the Bomberman's point of view. We built the FPB mode to satiate that desire. There was some trial and error before reaching its current state, like testing out a first-person shooter style of camera. However, we still respected that the traditional gameplay was about scanning the battlefield and thinking things through. It's different, but it's still the same traditional traditional game of Bomberman, so I think we've done a good job.
No, you didn't.
Okay, we need to unpack this. FPB stands for First Person Battle, but it's not first person at all, but rather a weird third person behind the back sort of thing. It simultaneously shows less of the battlefield than the original games, but it's also not as interesting or novel than if it were actually in first person. So this literally pleases nobody and was one of the main complaints fans and reviewers lobbied against Act Zero. It also had a life bar and a Bomberman game. They even knew this was all a big mistake because FPB is its own separate mode, as the standard mode takes place from a more traditional perspective. Why this just wasn't a toggle in the options is anyone's guess. Now, that's just how the action is presented, the camera angle it's framed in, so what could be worse than that? Well, remember all those great memories you had of playing 2, 4, or even 8 player Bomberman with friends? Well, forget all that, because for reasons that can only be attributed to, I guess, the focus on Xbox Live, all forms of local multiplayer were axed. Not only did this indeed piss off much of the fanbase, as it might be the first mainline Bomberman title since the NES original with no local multiplayer, it also ensured that the game would be pretty much useless in the future, as, yeah, no one has logged on to the servers in years. Except for maybe stop skeletons from fighting.
Good thing she's got those ropes attached to her chest. Hold them puppies up.
Now we've saved the best or worst for last. One of the most fundamental of fundamentals that Act Zero lacked was the complete absence of any sort of save feature. No autosaves, manual saves, and before you say passwords, there wasn't any passwords. So you better clear those 99 levels on one single life, because if you don't, you start the whole thing over from the beginning. Hope you don't mess up on, like, level 98. I'm surprised the game didn't try to make passwords edgy somehow, like biocodes or bomb memories, which lets you save the tortured, mutated thoughts of your Bomberman or whatever. Regardless, this completed the triumvirate of massive gameplay issues that blew up this attempt at trying to reboot the franchise. So with all of these problems, as well as the aesthetic choices that fans didn't really appreciate, it might come as no surprise that Bomberman X-Zero is one of the lowest rated titles of the generation and was a sales disaster for Hudson Soft. John Lee, in his article, stated, "Bomberman X-Zero was a low point for the company. Sales for the series dropped to a low of about 20,000 units from a high of more than a million copies per game during its peak in the 90s. Well, that's only because the haters and detractors spread their baby lies about X-Zero and weren't real gamers, according to a blog post on Hudson Soft's now defunct official website. I'm here to tell you that Bomberman X-Zero is actually pretty damn cool. If you think I'm talking out of my ass, check out my Xbox Live gamer card. I'm actually playing the game and enjoying it. Forget the haters out there and all the lemmings who jumped on the bashing bandwagon. This is the first Bomberman game that tracks player stats on a worldwide level. So all you smack talkers out there, it's time to put your money where your mouth is. You get scored for every kill, so for those of you with the realest skills can boast while people like me giggle when we accidentally win. But if you're still a hater, then go play your Bomberman PSP, bah, and go play with your Hello Kitty toys too. This I command. If you'd like to know more about Act Zero, want to check out some snazzy wallpapers, hit up our official game page now. God, okay. Bomberman is fine nowadays. There are more traditional titles that came out after, so it didn't even kill the series there. If you know of any other really bad or stupid game, I can't even finish it. Just give post a comment in the comments below or go to the Patreon and check that out. Go play with your Hello Kitty toys. Are you serious?